strapped into straitjackets, shackled in irons, locked into isolation cages, and blasted with the extremely cruel method of electroshock therapy, the damaged soul screamed so loudly they could be heard in the nearby town. Administrators responded by buying a flock of 20 peacocks, so the birds' screeches would drown out the noise. For 128 years, thousands of men and women endured the worst of Victorian-era treatment in the Beechworth Lunatic Asylum in Australia, located a few hours outside of Melbourne. The large asylum was built on a hill where the breezes were thought to blow away whatever caused the insanity. Patients suffered from schizophrenia, severe depression, bipolar disorder, alcoholism and opium addiction. But many others had no business being there at all. With admission requiring only the signature of two people, Beechworth became a convenient depository for society inconveniences, quarrelsome teenagers, difficult wives and regular folks unfortunate enough to cross a police officer the wrong way. Built in 1867 and self-sustaining off the food and livestock from surrounding farmland, Beechworth held 1,200 patients at capacity -600 men, and 600 women. An estimated 3,000 patients died there before it closed in 1995, leaving only their memories, and some sat their spirits. In what is called the most haunted area of the facility, a longtime and long dead staff member known as Matron Sharp, beloved for her kindness to patients, is said to glide down the stairway in her gray hood and period dress. Witnesses say she appear in the dreaded Gravilla wing, where electroshock therapy was carried out, sometimes on many patients at the same time. Other specters include a former kitchen worker named Tommy, who is reputed to tug at people's shirts, and a mischievous girl who tries to talk to visitors but can't get the words out. Now owned by La Trobe University, much of Beechworth has been converted into a hotel and conference center, with paranormal tours at night.